Hey everyone, it's Derek here with another video, and today we are going to talk about this, the Apple Watch, iWatch, Apple Series 3 Apple Watch, and this is specifically the 38 millimeters because my wrists are tiny. The reason why I think we're here to talk about this, and the reason why I even contemplated buying this, is because it essentially will replace these three things. These three things right here. So here we have a nice movement watch, and here we have a Garmin 920 XT, which is my fitness watch, and here is my heart rate monitor, the heart strap right here. And we're going to see if this can replace all three of these. Now, this Apple Series Watch, Apple Watch Series 3, is not the one with LTE. Now, that would replace this also. So, well, at least in my opinion, it should replace this, if they were trying to attempt that at all. But I don't think that's really the angle that they were going for. But anyways, let's get down to business and let's talk about the design. So I think the design of the Apple Watch is very, very nice, very, very sleek. I like that it's a smaller screen. I would probably prefer this one over the 38, even though I've had this for about 2 weeks now. And I think this is honestly the better way to go if you have a smaller petite wrist like myself. And like I said, I fit into the third band here, so it's not like I'm like bulging out of this one, so I still have to get into the third one here. So I'd say if you have smaller petite wrist like myself, or if you have a larger wrist, obviously you should probably go for the 42 or just a larger band in general. So, the design I like. I am not a big fan of this particular band. Now, which is nice is that they have the quick release bands, which you can switch these off really easily. And they also have a multitude of different bands and a multitude of different third parties that actually provide bands, which is really, really nice. I think that's a really good option. And, well, hell, for this was $350 total with Apple Care. And yeah, I mean, honestly, when I add these three things up, they add up to about the same price as this. So it's kind of a direct comparison to a watch that essentially an outdated watch that's $200, a watch that cost $100 from Movement. So that honestly is really interesting to think about, because I was looking for the entire solution. I thought this would be the end-all be-all watch. And to be frank, my conclusion is that it isn't. So let's talk more about the functionality and more of what people would use this for and what I specifically tested out and what I used it for. Me in particular, I do a lot of this. Hell, like 90% of what I would do, or the reason why I wanted this, was because I wanted it to be good at this, which is running, GPS, heart rate. That's all I wanted it to be good at. And, you know, to be able to get my laps and my mile times and so on and so forth. It's okay at this. And why do I say it's okay at this? Well, a lot of people, at least a lot, I've watched so many reviews of people talking about Apple's stock workout app that they have on stock on the actual watch. And it's okay. It's good at tracking. From my particular use, the three or four runs that I've used it with, it's been pretty okay. My only issue is that this, the heart rate sensor. Every single run that I did, it was off by at the very least 10 beats per minute. And I don't know if you're watching this, you're probably, if you're 10 beats off, then it's a pretty big deal. And there are lots of spikes, and I hear a lot of people talk about sort of this technology as saying that it's pretty good for running. I have not specifically seen that, especially in this watch, but compared to this chest strap, but for my specific case, I'm looking for a fitness watch more so than a fashionable watch. Support has come out for a lot of different apps, so like Strava, different things like Map My Run, and the Nike Run Club app is also one of the things that comes on it. And honestly, I'm not entirely sure which one I like the best, but I definitely don't like the stock workout app. The Nike Run Club app actually shows you the route that you ran on your watch. However, my issue was I saw it on the watch, but then I saw it on my actual phone, and they were different. Not sure why, but they were different. And that kind of annoyed me and was weird. Strava was really good. It actually gives you notifications, and as well as the Nike Run Club app. The workout app that it comes with stock did not, it gave you a buzz every time you came to a mile marker, but it would not tell you how fast you ran or anything like that. It would stop and pause and show you how much you ran, but that was about it. Anyways, the Map My Run app, not much better. It didn't notify me at all when I hit a mile marker or anything like that, which was super annoying. So overall, I think that the best use case for this watch is simply notifications. So if you want to receive notifications when this is in your pocket and you just want to see at a glance what's going on, so whether it's Facebook, whether it's emails, whether it's, I don't know, the weather alerts, text messages, phone calls, what have you, and replying to those things. So answering a phone call on your watch, pretty decent, sounds pretty good, not too bad. Clarity is pretty decent as well. I have some sound clips here if you want to check that out.
Hey, how's it going? This is Derek, and I'm driving stick shift right now in the neighborhood and talking with my hand on the steering wheel. So just wondering how this is coming through. Stick shift right now. Now I'm holding it up to my face and talking into the watch.
Hey, what's going on? This is Derek Moy talking to you on my iWatch. And this is just a regular room sitting on the couch.
Also, using Siri to reply back to text messages is actually pretty decent as well. What I like about this is that for this point of Siri, you can actually say something. So it's similar to text to talk or talk to text. And when you hit the button, it basically says what you want, and then you can edit it, or you can cancel it, or you can send it. It's not like where you do the voice activated, hey Siri, or whatever.
I'm not sure I understand.
Yeah. So it's not that automated thing that you get when you say, hey Siri. What time is it?
The time is 2:47 p.m. It's 2:47 p.m.
It's pretty decent for that, but I'm not sure how many people would actually answer the phone on your actual watch, mainly because why would you do that? Why wouldn't you just answer the phone normally so people can't hear you? Normally, phone calls are fairly private, and you would answer a phone, whether it be, you know, your earbuds or what have you. Moving on, let's talk about some of the features that I think it's actually useful for. So, like I mentioned before, messaging people back at a glance, or if you just wanted to reply back with a quick text message like okay or smiley face, what have you, that's pretty easy. Seeing different notifications without actually looking at your phone, that's really good. I don't deny that. And I actually have a lot of Apple products. I'm not the biggest proponent of Apple products. I prefer Android and anything other than an actual Apple. The reason why I use it is because Final Cut Pro. And other than that, that's really the only reason I really, really like it. Let's talk about the one proponent that I think that it's very, very useful for. And that's connecting this with AirPods, any type of Bluetooth stereo headphones, and listening to music, because you can store music on here, which is really nice. You don't need the LTE connection for thousands and thousands of songs that you can get on Apple Music. I think that's probably one of the biggest proponents of this, is that you can get some earpods or AirPods or any Bluetooth thing to connect to this, and you can listen to music with the internal storage. Now, the 38mm non-LTE comes with 8GB, and that specifically is not very large, but for most of things that you would be doing, it's probably enough music for you to listen to. The problem is that it's similar to any MP3 player, where you're going to have to switch the music on and off if you transfer the music on and off based on what you want to listen to in that particular session or that particular week. So let's talk about the performance of this particular product. Now, Apple said that this is 70% faster than the last Apple Watch with its new W2 chip. And I feel really, really bad. Sorry, Andy, I know you have one. CG, you might have one too. But compared to the Apple Watch Series 2, this apparently is a lot faster. And that's terrible, in my opinion, because this is pretty slow. It's not that good. It seems like it needs more RAM because it hiccups on me, it stops working, the heart rate monitor is a piece of crap, and maybe I have a defective model, I'm not sure. But quite honestly, I am not impressed with this. And usually I like to be impressed by this type of technology, or this sort of product with that much promise. And I really wasn't. Honestly, I was thinking smartphone in my watch. And its features really limit you. And it'll make you dependent on another accessory. And that's really what Apple did, again, is they made another accessory. And that's what really annoys me about Apple, is that they keep throwing accessories at you which make you think you need them, but you don't need them at all. I get that the ecosystem and having a text message show up on here and here and on my MacBook is really, really cool, but honestly, I'm not buying it. I'm not buying it. This is definitely going back, and what do you guys think? I am being very picky about this because this is a very expensive piece of technology. This is essentially buying this. I mean, if you buy one with LTE, that's, you're ringing around $500, and that to me is insanity for something that really doesn't do what I think it should do, which is it should track GPS signal, which it was accurate, but I had some discrepancies here and there. More or less, I would have issues with this one versus my Garmin. And heart rate, it was terrible. It was not detecting it, and it did not detect my sleep automatically, which the app said it would, and it does not. So I have to push a button to say I'm going to sleep, even if I just randomly pass out, which is annoying. I want it to be able to detect, like, so this is supposed to be an activity tracker, GPS, sport watch, everything. It does everything mediocrely, in my opinion. Now, that may be different from your opinion, but that's, in my experience, this is how it is. And I would definitely hold off on buying one of these if you haven't bought one already. And I would really want you to know that this technology is getting better. Is it there yet? No. But it's getting better. I think this is similar to that robot vacuum that I reviewed. It's a piece of technology to talk about, and that's it. It's something to be showy, to say you're into technology and it's cool, but it's not there yet. I'm a proponent of it. I just want it to get better. I want it to be, you know, iPhone level speed, dependency, and this just isn't. Like, I go take a shower and suddenly I can't use it. I want to pause the timer. I can do that by pressing these two buttons. And on each app it's different, where I'm double tapping or swiping to the left and pausing it. It's the usability of this is very not the greatest, and I think they really need to improve upon that before I'm ready to buy some piece of technology like this. This thing has buttons on it because when you get sweaty, they know that you won't be able to touch the screen. And I think Apple needs to take a lesson in the book of GPS watches if they want to even market this as a watch that you can work out in. You have to update the software so that this can pause it, one button can pause it, one button can start it, and one button can make a lap. But yeah, that's just my opinion. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Thank you all for watching, and thank you all for listening to my little rants here and there. Hope to see you in the next video. Make sure you subscribe. And if you want to keep this channel going, make sure you throw down a like. And I have a Patreon. So if you're into it, support me on Patreon. You'll see the videos before they get released onto YouTube. It's about 5 to 10 days, depending on where you are in the world and how much I like you. Anyways, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.